So, dear friends, I drove my Tesla from work to home today, and I have about 240 kilometers from work to home. I'm working in a place called Randers, and I live in the south of Denmark near the German border on an island called Als. And I drove my Tesla down to I get in my garage where I'm parked now. Let me just show you. I drove my Tesla to its limits. When I drive it on the AP1 on the autopilot, 250 kilometers per hour. I'm turning this on the motorway when I'm driving, and it's just following the traffic. And if I want to overtake, I just hit the blinker, or what do you call it? I don't know what you call it in English. The turn signal. Oh yes, the turn signal, I remember. And I follow the traffic home from Randers, where I'm working. And about 10 kilometers before I was home, I can see I won on -2% in the car battery limit. And when I get home, because I'm driving fast, the battery is hot, so I drive into the reverse into the garage, and waiting here instead of starting to charge the car right away, because I think it's better the battery package is cooling a little bit down. So I wait normally to midnight to charge the battery, and then I'm home about between 8 and 9 in the evening. So 2-3 hours I'm waiting, and then I'm setting the charger to start charging at 12 o'clock. But I tried here at 10 o'clock to go, went out to my car, and nothing happens. The display laid up, and it's shutting down when I'm sitting in the car, and it's showing very low battery like this. And I was a little bit surprised. I've never tried that before. And so I push the brake pedal and nothing happens. And but suddenly the screen was turning on, and I turn off the schedule charging and start the car to charge. So the battery was empty. So so far you can drive it down, or I know there's still something back. I cannot remember how much, but it's quite fun to try. And now about 6 hours and 35 minutes, the battery will be at 100%. This is the third time I driving the car to zero. The last two times I tried one with a supercharger. I just driving far, I was fast on the way from where I live and go to the next supercharger. And then I circled in the roundabout about 10 times on a little, about 5 minutes or so in a roundabout. It's maybe looking stupid, but this was quite late in the night, so I don't know. Anybody knows is a Tesla guy driving in a roundabout for so long time. But it's going a little bit downhill from roundabouts to the supercharts. And so when a car was saying it's shutting down, I couldn't go in neutral, and then I rolled down the hill and couldn't go to the supercharts and start charging there. And it's on the supercharts, I was going up to 100 kilowatt because I'm a 60 amp battery package, so it's not go so higher than this. I had never tried it higher than this, maybe 101 or so, but the limits it's 100. And it's still my car has driving about 17,000 kilometers now, and it's still the variance of the battery pack is the same. There's no different from the day I got the car. I think it's as I couldn't remember I was driving 10,000 kilometers when I bought it, or 13,000 kilometers when I bought it. But if you have the little battery packets as I have, you nearly almost go on 100%. Not when I'm driving here at normal, when I'm home from work, I'm just sitting to the limit to 90%. But the rest of the time, if I'm going to travel more than 100 kilometers or 50 miles, 60 miles, I always put it on 100%. But I'm always try to it's not has to be holding still with 100% on the battery for a long time. I'm trying to set the limit so that it's about when I have to drive, it's going to 100%, or maybe 10 minutes it has been on 100%, and then I'm going driving. So the battery in my 2014 model here is working very, very good, and I'm very happy about the car. Of course, it's 85 battery package, or 90 or 100 is of course nice to have, but for my job and what I'm doing with this car, a 60 kilowatts battery is enough, I will say. Okay. Just try to film myself a little bit so you can see who you're talking to or who you're seeing. But what I'm doing now is set the battery limit to 100%, and then to tonight it will be on 100%, and I will let it be there to in the morning when I wake up at 7 o'clock. It's will have been balanced. The battery has been balanced. It's take all the cells and fill the right amount of energy in every cell. So so the battery's packets is balanced, what we call it. The car is running 100% perfect. I just got a new motor in it. The electric motor was making some noise. I couldn't hear when I drove from 0 to 50 kilometers per hour, and just so light on the throttle, I couldn't hear a screeching sound. So, and I took it to Tesla in Aarhus, and the technician or the mechanic was driving with me for wants to hear it, and I just started it up, and I would go out of the parking place, and then he said, stop, we can go back, I can hear it. So your bearings in the motor was worn, so they replaced it in a few hours, and I get a new update on the motor and everything, so it's very fast, and of course it's one in for the warranty, so I have to pay nothing, and they do a tremendous job by Tesla in Aarhus. I'm very satisfied with the job what you're doing there. But I will try to balance the battery at 100%. So tomorrow I will make a new video so you can see when it's on 100%. What you expect many see when they try to balance the battery is maybe going to 98 or 99, and I had tried this. I had tried this three times now to balance the battery or drive it down to zero, and it's my third time I'm doing this. And it's difficult sometimes to get it to 200% by charging. So in the morning when I wake up, I can see it's 99. I just set the limit down to 80, and then after a few seconds, I put it up to 100% again, and then it will start momentarily to charging. And sometimes I'm locking, and then it's starting to charge, and then it's going up to 100%. So sometimes I tried it four or five times, and nothing happens, and it stops by 99, and then I just drove away, and then a few days later I tried to get it to 100% again, and then it's going to 100% without problems. So this was this working quite good this way for me. But the battery packets, I will say, is I think is 100% okay on this car here, and I've driven it for 70,000 kilometers now, a little bit over 70,000 kilometers, and I'm very happy about this car. I will never ever drive something with petrol or diesel or something like this for daily drive car. But I have my 650 horsepower Toyota Supra. I had over 1,000 horsepower Supra, and I still love it. It's like having you know, just for fun in the weekends I take this out, and I'm a race guy, so I do a lot, or have lots of friends doing race in Denmark, and been following racing for many years. I worked on a racetrack in Padborg Park in the south of Denmark. It's a nice fast racetrack. Been there for a few years and worked for Tom Petersen down there, and so, and we had this year we had a big EV event down on the track, and here in Denmark we tried to make an international EV track weekend for people that wants it. So we will try to next year to do the same, and it was quite fun to drive with a Tesla and Golf, and yeah, there were many different EV cars down there, Nissan Leafs, and yeah, you name it, it was there, and it was fun to drive on a track. We had different kinds of race down there, and we were on different things we did down there, but I will tell you more about this later. But okay, my plan is tomorrow morning when I wake up at 7 or 8, I will make a video again about how much energy I have absorbed. I can see it's going up to about 10-11 kilowatts now. I have no double charger in my car, so I can go about 10 kilowatts, but normally it stands on 11, but this is because this is now it's on 11. I can see astro measuring in, but okay, it's still 0 kilowatts hour in the battery, so it'll take a long time. It's my house is, I think, is sweating now, but it's quite late, so oh, it's over right now. I can see. But okay, that's too much light here. I can see that. That's better. That's my old Supra. That was quite fun. This was a TT500 from Japan, and the drive line we built ourselves in the home. It's got lots of trophies, but not for racing. It was a show car. It was a very wild car, and we had lots of fun with the car. So, okay. See you later and sleep well, Tesla, and everybody that's looking at this. Good night.